Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Dr. Kalam IAS Academy. Today, I'll walk you through one of the most important aspects in UPSC preliminary examination. The secret of UPSC civil service preliminary examination. Three topics. By just reading these three topics, you will be getting 20% of the marks needed to clear civil service preliminary examination. I hope many of you have got astonished, but it's true. By the time I complete my presentation, you will appreciate and you will believe that I am correct and you will follow that. So with this note, let's begin. So this is a brief about me. A very important pertinent aspect with respect to myself is with respect to clearing 7 times preliminary examination, that is writing 7 times mains. So I feel I am one of the right person to advise what you have to do to clear the preliminary examination. With this background, I would just introduce to our new batches also. We are starting 2 new batches at Dr. Kalam IAS Academy. 2 new batches, brand new batches. One is online batch starting on June 5th. And for first 50 students, we are offering online coaching at just 10,000 rupees. So for just 50 students, it is 10,000. After that, it will be 40,000. The other thing, other is like offline course, it will be starting on July 1st. The offer price is only 50,000. The original price is 90,000. Your admission and your success in civil service examination is just one call away. Take your phone and just dial the number below if you have any queries. Coming to our presentation, the secret of UPSC civil service preparation, that is with respect to preliminary examination. So what is that needed to clear preliminary examination? What is the secret of clearing preliminary examination? As I have told, I have cleared 7 times prelims. I have cleared prelims in almost all the recent formats in the past 10 years, 15 years. I have cleared prelims with optional and GS. And I have cleared prelims with CSAT and general studies, both as compulsory. And I have also cleared prelims with prelims like GS and GS as the main qualifying and CSAT as just qualifying thing. So with this background, let me analyze the things first. So what is the perfect cutoff marks which is needed to clear the preliminary examination? As you all know by the previous year trend, it is 150 marks. If you want to clear preliminary examination, you should get 110 marks in paper 1. That means that you have to answer net 55 questions correct. This is a very simple thing that you understand. Then how to get these 55 questions correct? Getting 55 net questions correct will get you through civil service preparation. Then how? For this, first and foremost, number one thing is, in my past like 20 years experience as a student and a faculty, what I have come to know with my own experience and the experience of successful candidates, almost no one can answer plus or minus 35 questions in preliminary examination without any ambiguity. I repeat, max you can answer some 30 to 40 questions without ambiguity. So you have to make sure that these 35 questions you will be answering without any ambiguity. Next you will be left with another 65 questions. In these 65 questions, it is left to your choice whether you are attending all the 65 or whether you are attending 50 or you are attending just 40. You should see that by any method, elimination, deduction, any educational guess, anything, you should see to it that you are getting 20 to 25 net correct. So by this, you will be crossing 110 mark. And by this, you will clear the preliminary examination. So then you may ask the question, like how to answer these 35 questions without any ambiguity. This is the real secret. Means the answering 35 questions without ambiguity means like pinpoint, yes, this is the answer. No guesswork here, no guesswork permitted here. So how you will get to know, make choices, how you have to prepare to see that you answer 35 questions correct? In that, the secret of clearing prelims examination is answering 35 questions correctly without any ambiguity. For this, what you have to do? What is the secret? For that, based on previous year questions, based on the analysis of the trend, you have to come up with some of the topics where UPSC is always asking the questions. I repeat, there are some areas which I will be dealing. There are some areas where UPSC is frequently asking and definitely in future also will ask. There are many areas which you have to master. So at this point, I would like to tell one point. How are the competitive exams made difficult? What is the reason for preliminary exam to be difficult? One of the reason is changing the scope, changing the trend. Mean to say that in 1 year, they may ask 20 questions from general studies, like current affairs. In another year, he may ask just 4 questions. So by changing the trend, UPSC is making the question paper difficult. Mean to say that if every year 20 questions are coming from the preliminary examination, if 20 questions are coming from the current affairs section, then everybody would prepare current affairs very thoroughly. So by changing the trend, UPSC is making the question paper tough. But there are some areas, there are some topics where questions always come. So you have to master those areas. In this section, I will discuss 3 topics from which more than 10 questions are coming. Means more than 10 questions, definitely. Means to say that 25, like you have to answer 55 questions correct to get through prelims. Here, I will be discussing 3 topics where more than 10 questions, means to say that nearly 20% of the marks required for clearing the prelims examination will be in your hand. So let's proceed. What are these 3 topics where more than 10 questions bound to come? Definitely they will come. I'll bet on that. Because this has been the case for the last 10 years. I have analyzed the last 20 years question papers, and almost this is a foolproof strategy where you can bank upon. What are these? One, first topic is maps. I hope you know this, but the main crux here is how to read this. Every year there is not even a single year where there are less than 3 to 5 questions in preliminary exams based on maps. Very, very important. But the real challenge, the secret of reading maps is like how to read. So how to read maps? Map is one of the important topic. So how to read, how to go about it? In that, most of the students make this mistake. They read the entire atlas, many pages. This is a wrong strategy which you shouldn't follow. Don't read the entire atlas. Any atlas is good enough, but you should have a specific atlas which you often refer. So don't read the entire atlas from cover to cover. Then what do you have to read? Just read 2 maps. Just read 2 maps. Get thorough. Internalize the 2 maps. What are they? They are India and another is world. India and world. These 2 maps you have to internalize. In that, again, this India and world, again 2 types. One is physical and another is political. So India political, India physical. World political, world physical. These 2 maps you have to internalize. You have to read daily. Then the next stage is NCERT geography maps. They are very beautiful. Just take NCERT books. Just glance through the maps. Just a glance of a map in the NCERT geography textbook will show you the soils in India. Similarly, all other things. So just read 2 maps, internalize India and world, it's enough. But you have to read it daily. Please keep 10 to 15 minutes of your time daily for map reading. Here, you will definitely get 3 to 5 questions. Take it from me. Next, Government of India schemes and programs. This is one of the most important area and also difficult area. This has been neglected by most. Everybody knows this, but they can't, many fail to master this. What is the reason? Because they won't be knowing the exact strategy. So how to go about the Government of India programs, schemes? This is very important. In many years, in many previous year question papers, there were many instances where nearly 10 questions have come from this topic, Government of India schemes and programs. So how to go about this? First thing is India Yearbook. India Yearbook is the source, is a UPSC book from which UPSC has been picking the questions. So go through India Yearbook, where some of the important chapters where the Government of India schemes and programs are there. Please go through them. Next, most important is budget. In budget, new schemes will be announced. Please go through them. India 2020 covers the schemes only till 2019 December. But budget will be having all the programs of the next year and also some of the analysis of the current going programs. So budget and India Yearbook, just refer these 2 things. After that, very important thing. If you go through this, you'll find many, more than 100 schemes and programs, more than 100. So it is very, very difficult for you to remember. Then what is the way out? There you have to select very important schemes. Say for example, MGNREGA, like there are some 10 programs you have to select and you have to prepare A to Z of them. Other 90 to 100 or more, just know the gist. That's enough. This is about Government of India schemes and programs. Next, committees, reports, index, treaties, international, regional, bilateral groupings, and Indian diaspora. This is a very, very important aspect. And if you prepare for this, almost every year, 3 to 5 questions will appear. So by these three topics, maximum, you may get even 20 questions. There have been instances previously. So you have to internalize these things. So in this, with respect to last topic, that committees, reports, all these things, you have to go through the bilateral, regional, global groupings, agreements involving India or affecting the Indian interest, important international institutions, agencies, and fora, and their structure and mandate. By covering these things, these three topics, I am sure that you will get more than 10 questions. If you internalize these three topics, definitely you can clear the preliminary examination to a greater extent. To brush up, the secret of clearing UPSC civil service prelims is you have to see that 35 questions you have to answer without any ambiguity. Among the rest 65 questions, you have to make educated guess. Use any method so that you are correcting minimum 20 to 25 questions correct. So by doing this, you will be clearing the prelims. In that, how to get the 35 questions correct? Is there are some topics where UPSC has been asking. In our further videos, we'll be coming with those topics. So what are these topics? The three topics, important topics, are MAPS, Government of India programs and schemes. Next, committees, report, index, treaties, and Indian diaspora. This is the real secret. My dear students, please internalize this. You can check out the previous year questions, and also I bet the same will be there in your 2020 preliminary examination. I take this opportunity once again to inform you our new batches, IAS 2021. First batch online on June 5th, just for 10,000 rupees. My dear students, it's an awesome offer. You won't get anywhere in India for 10,000 rupees, 10 months course, all the topics covered, prelims, mains, interview, all guidance, just by for 10,000. But my dear students, this is limited offer, only for 50 students. The admissions are in progress. Make sure that you are there. Next batch is tentatively July, based on COVID-19 things. The offer price is 50,000 rupees. This is also for just first 52 students. My dear students, if you have got any doubt, just take your phone and just call to the number below. Any doubt will be clarified. In our next session, I'll be coming with some of the tricks, some of the topics where UPSC has been asking. Till then, happy reading. Take care.